Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off this video, we can hopefully expect the fourth Falcon 9 launch of 2022 this coming week. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the CSG-2 mission is expected to lift off on Thursday 27th at 11:11 PM UTC or 6:11 PM Eastern Time. Also on the SpaceX fans website, you can see there is the fifth Falcon 9 launch of 2022 this coming week. The launch of Starlink Group 4-7 is expected to lift off on Saturday 29th. NASA had posted on Friday about the latest SpaceX Cargo Dragon returning to Earth. It said, with medical research and a retired microscope in tow, a SpaceX Cargo Dragon is scheduled to depart the space station at 10:40 AM Eastern Time Saturday, January 22nd for its trip back to Earth. SpaceX also posted a tweet yesterday about this Cargo Dragon capsule's return. They said, due to unfavorable weather in the splashdown locations off the coast of Florida, now targeting Sunday, January 23rd at 10:40 AM Eastern Standard Time for Dragon's departure from the space station. Space News has posted an article about another contract that has been awarded to SpaceX. It says, the US Air Force awarded SpaceX a $102 million 5-year contract to demonstrate technologies and capabilities to transport military cargo and humanitarian aid around the world on a heavy rocket. There was an interesting article related to SpaceX, Tom Cruise and Axiom Space. CNBC posted this article saying the producers of Tom Cruise's future space movie on Thursday announced plans to attach a studio to the International Space Station in development by Houston-based company Axiom. Talking about Axiom Space, they recently posted a tweet. It says, AX-1, the first ever private astronaut mission to the space station, is now targeting a March 31st launch due to additional spacecraft preparations and space station traffic. The multinational crew will conduct science, outreach and commercial activities during their 8 days on the ISS. Jeff Faust posted another tweet in relation to future Axiom missions. He said, at this morning's NASA Advisory Council Human Exploration and Operations Committee meeting, NASA's Phil McAllister says that in addition to the slip of the AX-1 private astronaut mission announced yesterday, AX-2 is now expected to fly early next year, not late this year. There was an interesting tweet posted related to SpaceX operations and plans in Florida. It says, SpaceX has submitted plans for Roberts Road West that includes a 320,000 square foot proposed building with a 192,000 square foot future proposed building expansion. Also included are two 20,400 square foot proposed buildings. Heading over to Boca Chica, work has been continuing on the orbital launch mount. Concrete forms have been spotted being put together at the launch site. In the production yard, here's a view of the tent recently moved. Here's a view of the construction progress on the wide bay. Musk posted a cool animation of how Super Heavy would be caught in the chopstick catching arms with the caption, maybe something like this. Space News posted an article related to the HLS contract and SpaceX working through the whole legal fiasco. At the end of the article, it says SpaceX did make progress during that hiatus, including completing 5 milestones such as tests of the Raptor engine. NASA reviewed that work and paid all 5 of those milestones. This single ring was recently spotted and moved into the high bay. This nice smooth nose cone was spotted in the fabrication tent. This new smooth nose cone was spotted moved out of the tent also. Here's a Starship common dome seen sitting out in the yard. This booster upper bulkhead was also seen being moved in the yard. This ship nose cone barrel section has been spotted assembled in the high bay. Here's a view again of the remains of GSE-4 after pressure testing to failure. Starship 20 was lifted off of suborbital pad B and onto the SPMTs to be moved. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, there are a load of dates scheduled. Currently, there is a road and beach closure for every weekday this coming week with closures from Monday 24th to Friday 28th. The aero covers for Booster 4's external components have now all been installed. To finish up today's video, we have another Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to say thank you to Mary or Boca Chica Gal and Nick Anzuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.